behind the New York Asian Film Festival. In fact, we created the New York Korean Film Festival over a decade ago, so it's really feels like coming home in a way. And it's we're very happy and excited to have a new home with the Museum of the Moving Image. It's a beautiful theater, and we have new talent to bring over. And we're also very excited to have this partnership with the Paris City. I'm sorry, I had one big glass of tequila. This is great Mexican restaurant across the street, you know. The tequila is really good. I strongly recommend it. So we're very pleased to have all these partners. You know, the organization we created is originally was not a professional organization. It's very much based on friendship, and I think having so many partners, so many friends with us to do this festival is really reflects the spirit of the organization. And Korean cinema has always been in our hearts. So in this sense, it's really an exciting moment for us to do this event together in Queens, and in again, I think it's a really magnificent space for this. So without any further ado, please welcome to the stage director Hong Won-chan and the beautiful actress Ko Ha-sung. Ko Ha-sung and Hong Won-chan, everybody. It's their first time in what? It's working. Great. It's their first time in New York City, so please give them a warm hug. I think they're a little bit nervous. We'll do a Q&A afterwards, but before that, before they watch this movie, do you have any words for the New York audience tonight, Director Hong and Ms. Ko?
영화 상영하기 전에 관객한테 하시고 싶으신 말씀 있으신지 감독님하고
Nice to meet you. I'm director of this movie. My name is Hong Won-chan. Thank you for coming here. I hope you enjoy my movie. Thank you.
Hello everyone, I'm Ha-sung Ko playing Imire in this office film. It's my first time New York and New York Korean Film Festival. I'm so glad to be here to meet you guys. Thank you. Enjoy the film. Thank you.
Thank you. I hope you enjoyed this satire about working in an office and being tortured by your colleagues and so on. Thank you. Staying with us. Please welcome back to the stage director Hong Won-chan and actress Ko Ha-sung. Thank you very much. So we'd like to ask you about your career as a screenwriter in the first place. How about your move from screenwriting? You work with Nam Hong Jin. I don't know, some of you might be familiar with The Chaser or The Yellow Sea, both great prime films as well. So I want to ask you about this switch from screenwriting to film directing.
네, 시나리오 작가로 먼저 활동을 시작하셨는데 이제 뭐 추격자의 남진 감독님이랑도 호흡을 맞추시고 그래서 그 시나리오 작가에서 감독으로서의 전환이 어떻게 이루어지게 되었는지
제가 그 작가를 할 때부터 연출을 하려는 생각을 가지고 있었던 것 같아요. 그래서 체이서로 크레딧 데뷔를 하게 됐고 또 다행히 취업자가 좋은 반응이 있어서 계속 또 작가를 활동을 하게 됐고 근데 그러면서도 연출에 대한 생각을 계속 가지고 있었는데 어느 시기가 돼서 이제는 내 작품을 만들고 싶다는 생각을 하게 됐고 그때 네, 오피스 시나리오를 받게 됐고 네, 이 작품 통해서 데뷔를 하게 된 것 같습니다.
So even when I started out as a screenwriter, I always had goals of directing. I did debut as a screenwriter for the film The Chaser. Fortunately, that got good responses from Korean audiences, so that followed into other writing gigs as well. But then there came a time where I thought that the time had come for myself to actually direct a piece or a project on my own. And that around that time was when I received the original screenplay for The Office, and so that's when I made the decision to make the transition.
Let me talk to Ms. Ko. So this is a big vehicle for you, and I'm wondering how you reacted to the script when you first read it. What attracted you to this story?
시나리오 받으실 때 이제 어떤 부분에서 끌렸는지 그리고 이제 어떤 점에서 이 역할을 하고 싶다고 결정한 일이 됐는지.
처음에 시나리오를 받았을 때는요, 좀 뭐랄까 걱정이 앞서긴 했어요. 이게 정말 쉽지만은 않은 역할이고 또 굉장히 이 작업을 시작하면은 굉장히 내면적으로 복잡해질 수도 있겠다 이런 생각이 들었는데, 근데 배우로서는 이렇게 입체적인 캐릭터를 만나는 것은 정말 행운 같은 일이에요. 그래서 거의 고민 없이 바로 하겠다고 했던 것 같아요.
So when I first received the screenplay, I was, I guess I would say I was worried at first because I knew that it wouldn't be, you know, like an easy role. But as an actor, I feel like, you know, being able to meet, and I felt that it would also be taxing psychologically. But I think as an actor, it's such a great, it's just great luck to be able to see such three-dimensional characters, and so after seeing that, I didn't hesitate in saying yes.
I'm curious about the kind of preparations you had doing this role. In America has a very particular style, method acting obviously is big here. So I'm wondering what kind of approach you had to embody this character. I don't know if you did you go around to, I don't know, local Korean offices or something?
네, 그 캐릭터 작업의 과정이 어땠는지 궁금하다고 하는데요. 그 미국 같은 경우에 이제 메소드 연기가 이제 뭐 이제 유명하게 알려져 있는데, 이 역할 준비를 하기 위해서 네, 어떤 과정 거치셨는지, 예를 들어서 뭐 이제 오피스 직접 찾아다녔는지 아니면 네, 어떤
굉장히 운이 좋았던 게 제가 이 영화를 이제 시작할 때쯤에 제 대학교 친구들이 다 인턴을 하고 있었어요. 그래서 주변에 레퍼런스가 너무 많은 게 이렇게 준비하는 연기자로서 되게 기쁜 일이거든요. 그래서 친구네 사무실도 가보고 뭐 복사도 배워보고 했는데 이게 지금 와서 생각해보면은 연기에 큰 도움이 되었을까 이런 궁금한 점이 있긴 해요. 그러니까 캐릭터의 외면적인 것보다는 이미래가 가진 그 깊은 열등감이나 자격지심 이런 것들을 연구하는 게 더 주된 이미래를 연기하는 주된 임무라고 생각했습니다.
So I was actually really lucky around the time I started working on this project was because all my friends from college were interning at some place or another. And so it was great to have, like as an actor, it's great to have reference points for your characters. So I would go to their offices. I would make copies and do whatever interns do. But ultimately, I don't know if that's what actually helped me figure out or find the character because I think the character Imire, it wasn't really much about the appearance or the outside stuff, you know, the stuff that she did. I think it was more about sort of delving into her sense of inferiority and her low self-esteem. So I think focusing on that was actually more helpful as an actor.